Dear friends, pray, welcome to our show. A story told in rhyme, we're glad that you can join us in our pantomime. A famous story, it recounts, you've heard of it, I am sure, of Jack and Beanstalk, and of how it stopped him being poor. We go at once into his house and whisper in Jack's ear, where he's asleep on the couch. Wake up, your mother's here!
Hi, my name is Jack. I live here with my mum and this evil cow.
They have to scrimp and save to take care of each other.
My mum was shouting at me.
And she doesn't believe that Jack has been looking for work each day.
Beautiful morning.
You should know so. Look, Missy.
Oh, what a beautiful day. I've never been there for a while. Death carries him. Wife goes through me.
Oh. Oh, Mum. Too much detail.
Well, have you found a job yet?
Well, with this economic downturn, I'm finding trouble finding anything.
Oh, come on, Jack. There's plenty of work out here. You don't look very hard enough.
Jack has tried to get a job, you know. He's just not been that lucky. He's worked on farms. He's worked down drains. But he'll just end up getting mucky. Jack and his mum need some real money. They just need to work out how, or else they will lose this lovely house.
Oh, hide. Uh-huh. Hide. I'm gonna sell the cow.
You can't sell Daisy. She's your friend. She gives you milk and butter.
Fart me be right. Do you wanna end up in the gutter?
Here is the landlord of this house that Jack and his mum rent. Every time she calls round, they say their money's spent.
Hello, I can hear you. Please do not lie. It's not funny. I need the rent. You should have paid us loads of money.
Hang on. I'm the one that does the rhyming round here. Thank you.
So there is somebody at home. Well, if you're going to pretend you're not in, I have no option but to give you this eviction notice. Shall I leave it on the porch?
Yeah!
Jack's mum knew he was right. It's market day tomorrow. They'll sell Daisy, though I know their hearts will be filled with sorrow.
Don't worry, Mum. I will go to the market tomorrow.
Well, may as well get a good price for Daisy. And don't come back here with the Xbox account on about.
You can trust me, Mum.
Lovely butters.
Come and get you. Meat and sausages. Two for a pound. Roll up, roll up.
Come and get meat. Fed meat. Come, give bed. Fifth bed.
Getting £3 and £2. Getting £3 and £2.
Come and get your fed meat. Fed meat. Fed meat.
So coming home, and Jack set off to go sell the cow. It wasn't very good at it. He just know not how.
We'll buy my cow. She's from Pembrokeshire. Will you buy my cow? Just loyal, tam and true.
I will not buy your cow. her coat is worn. She's seen better days.
Will you buy my cow?
Oh, no way, she smells.
She does smell?
Oh, yes, she does, mate.
Oh, no, she doesn't.
She does.
Oh, no, she didn't. Oh, be quiet.
So, coming home, he met a man who asked him for the time. Then he made the offer for the cow, so smally and crying.
I like your cow. Well, what have you been?
I have been off to market. My mum said get a good price for the cow.
The bee man wanted to say, he's been farmer all his life. Take care of your bees. Let her rain me patting queens.
Give me your cow for nothing!
What? No, thank you, I will pass.
Wait! I will offer you a deal. You've been like kings and queens. Give me your cow and my in return nose, magic beans. Yeah.
So Jack thought he'd want to create a deal, and he gives the cow away. I dare to think when he gets home what mother they would say.
Mom! Mom! You can't believe what happened.
What? You sold Daisy for millions of pounds. We're going on holiday. There's no Cabazoo for us.
Well, I did sell Daisy. I got something much better in return.
What? Is it Gary Barlow? Is it Gary Barlow? Where
no, Mum. Something much better.
What? Tell me.
Beans.
What?
Beans. Magic beans.
I'm booking 1 second. Do you think you're going? Magic beans? You must be mad.
Jack's mum didn't know what to do. She thought she might be as well be dead. They have to think something else to do. But now she's off to bed. Jack was very sorry. He thought the magic bean was great.
I'll give him back tomorrow, Mum.
No, Jack. It's far too late.
Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer true. I'm half crazy, all for the love of you. It won't be a stylish marriage. I can't. On the seat of a bicycle built for two.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. You like to move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it. I like to move it, move it.
Move it on up, nothing can stop me. Move it on up, no moving.
Now, audience, you'll surely think this tale you see is tragic.
Oh.
But don't forget, in pantomime, you need a little bit of magic. You can see the magic beans have grown into the sky. I don't know what will happen next. The night just inches by. So, in their beds, they passed the night until the sun broke through. He looked out of his bedroom that was built inside the eaves, but couldn't see his usual view. It was obscured by leaves. Jack.
OMG! What the heck is this? Mum!
I don't write.
No, you have to see this.
What the?
Beep!
This need to go on the Facebook.
Never mind Facebook. What the heck is in my garden?
Here comes Nancy. Oh. She is the girl that loves our hero, Jack. She milks the cow, she makes the cream, she's walking up the track. She's here to do the early chores, but Daisy's disappeared. Nancy, a giant plant that's blocking out the view.
Where did it come from?
I don't know. I'm in the dark like you. Nancy asked, why is this beanstalk here, attracting all the crowds of people who are wondering what's above the clouds? Jack knew that the man said they were magic beans, but he didn't think that this would happen. Jack, Mum and Nancy decide to call the local press. Mum knew there was money to be made. Let's just hope that they can make enough for the rent to be paid. Jack, I think you're going to be really famous.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, we've seen it. And besides, there's a giant peach growing in Gabon.
Giant peach, come on, woman!